today we're going to learn about how to use a microscope. This is probably a review from 7th grade science, maybe, but we want to make sure that everyone is familiar with what they're doing. When we carry a microscope, we're always going to carry it with two hands to make sure that it doesn't drop. We're going to store it with the cover on so that it doesn't get dusty. If you come around this side, when I'm ready to plug it in, I'm going to unwrap just as much cord as I need to get to the outlet. Once I've plugged it in, the on-off switch is here in the back, and I should see some light down here. If I don't see any light, I'm going to pull the plug out, hit the test and reset buttons in here, and then hopefully that's all that it needed, and I will now have power. The second thing we want to know is how to look at a prepared slide. A prepared slide is one that a manufacturer made, where it's got something stained in the middle, and then it's got a label on the sides so you know what you're looking at. I'm going to take my sample and put it under the stage clips. Some people think these are musical instruments, but they're not. So once you put your slide in place, they help it to move not quite as quickly. First thing I'm going to do is find my sample under the scanning lens. And let's talk about what the three lenses we have are. The shortest one is the scanning lens. And you know it's in place when you hear kind of a little click. So I'm going to find my object here, turn the revolving nose piece to look at the low power lens. And then once I've focused it here, then I'm going to switch to the high power lens. All right, so starting again, I'm going to focus this under the scanning lens. I want to keep just one eye as I'm looking at my object. And I can use both the coarse adjustment knob and the fine adjustment knob to focus my item. Once I've focused it, I want to make sure it's centered in my field of view. Then I'm going to switch to the low power lens, and hopefully all I have to use is the fine adjustment knob to make my object look really clear. Again, center it to the middle, and then switch to the high power lens. When we're using the high power objective or lens, we only use the fine adjustment knob. We don't want to push the stage into the lens, damaging it. And if the scope is working right, that's all that you should need. Why is it important to center your object? Well, here's why. On the scanning lens, you see everything in the outer big circle. As you move to the low power lens, you see less distance. So you're only going to see what's in the second circle. And under the high power lens, you only see what's in the very center. So if this is your object under the scanning lens and you don't move it at all, it will seem to have disappeared when you go to the higher powers. Also, we should know how to do magnification. Magnification is multiplying the eyepiece, which is up on the top, times the objective lens you're using. And the objective lenses have the magnification written right on them. The other thing you want to potentially adjust is the amount of light. And these new microscopes have two adjustments. There's a light dim switch down here that will adjust the amount of light. And there's a diaphragm underneath where there's a little handle that you just slide it back and forth. And that will help you make more or less light. Sometimes it's actually easier to see the item with less light if it's fairly clear. Okay, sometimes you're going to make your own slides, and we call those wet mount slides because you're using water. This is the slide, and this is a plastic cover slip. The slides will clean and use over and over again. The cover slip, at the end of the day, you may throw away. So to make a slide, I simply put my item that I want to look at on the slide and add some water. A drop or two should be enough. And then when I'm putting the cover slide on, I want to put it on at an angle and sort of let it drop from one side to the other so that it will squish the water out and not create a bubble. If you look at your slide, and this is what you see, you are seeing an air bubble, and you'd want to take the cover slip off and try again. The last thing we need to talk about is cleaning up. So when I'm done cleaning up, I will remove my slide, change the lens back to the scanning lens. Pull out the plug using my hand at the plug and not on the cord. Replace the cover. And then we're just going to often store these in the middle on the table so that they don't get knocked off. That is Microscopes Made Easy.